This was made for Allied Artists, which had previously been Monogram Pictures, a very low rent studio that was home to the Bowery Boys and Bamba the Jungle Boy. They thought that they wanted to sort of class up their act a bit in the 1950s and start making somewhat more expensive films. And this was one of them. Walter Wanger, the producer of this film, was actually a very accomplished and a great producer. He produced some great movies like Foreign Correspondent. But he had a bad period in his career where he had a huge flop with a movie called Joan of Arc. And then went to Eagle Lion Studios, which is a very small studio, and did a number of really interesting low-budget movies like The Black Book. But he made the mistake of shooting his wife's lover in the groin and was sentenced to prison. And so he went to prison for a while, and again, while he was in prison, as often happens, he became interested in prison reform. So when he came out, he talked the Allied Artists Company, which is a low-rung company, which is about all he could hope for at that point, into making a movie called Riot in Cell Block 11, which was actually shot at Folsom Prison, and of which there is a great new Criterion DVD, if you've never seen it. And to direct it, he chose Don Siegel, who was a montage expert who worked at Warner Brothers. And when you ever see a movie like Casablanca or Action in the North Atlantic, whenever those spinning headlines come out and there's ships blowing up and dissolves and clocks ticking, that's all Don's work. And he did a number of pictures and worked his way up. And the surprise success of Riot in Cell Block 11 led Wanger to say, well, this is the guy to do my science fiction picture. Now, there was still a bit of a approbation about doing a science fiction picture in the 50s. It was not considered high class. And when the studio decided to add Invasion Of to the title of The Body Snatchers, it sort of dropped it another rung. And so they decided that they thought it would be good to class up the act by having an introduction by either Edward R. Murrow or Orson Welles to put the picture in perspective. That, as it happened, never turned out. But during the making of the film, which is fairly faithful to the original story, they succeeded too well, because at the initial previews, the audience was so terrified by the end of the movie that the previews were adjudged a failure, and the studio decided that they wanted to add a wraparound at the beginning and end, which was actually shot at Allied Artists Studios, which later became KCET, and it's a brick facade building, and it still exists. And in fact, the opening scene of this movie, you can still tell it's the same place that you could see right off of Sunset. And a lot of people have decried the addition of these scenes because they took away the bleakness of the ending. It's still an open end. I mean, it doesn't tell you that everything's going to be okay. It tells you that maybe everything might be okay.